What's going on, YouTube? SciGuy29 coming at you here for a video. Special edition tonight. Happy National Beer Day. Just had to make a video for tonight. Couldn't let Crafts and Cards go by on National Beer Day without a salute to beer. So, not only that, but was I excited when I went to the grocery store the other day and I found this. And this is what I'm excited about right there. This is a brewery from Eugene, Oregon called Hop Valley. And if you've never been to Eugene, beautiful place, Willamette Valley, you're an hour from mountains, you're an hour from the ocean. Great place, just a fun college town. My niece lives out there, went to her wedding a couple years ago, well, 5 years ago now, 6 years ago, 8 years ago, whatever it is. Had a great time, love the place, and this was my favorite brewery. So when I saw this at my grocery store, I thought, that's a good thing. Let's go ahead and crack it open. This is called Bubble Stash IPA, cryo-hopped. Now you're probably going, what does that mean? Well, that's a really good question I don't really know the answer to. Let's pour it up here. All right, giving you a slightly different view of the bar tonight. This is behind the bar. Opposite side of usually we got the beer fridge, like the Iowa State Magnets. Got my Coors Light on. Got my usual Miller Genuine Draft Baseball Light. That guy right there is actually an old bourbon display. Antique bourbon. Found that in an antique store. Oh, no, geez. 8-10 years ago. So, cheers. Good stuff. Good stuff. Different angle, like I said, so things are kind of messed up. But this is 6.2 ABV, 45 IBUs, so up there for me. Cryo Hops, it says, is a registered trademark. And it says, our stash of Mosaic Cryo Hops bring a blend of fruity tropical flavors and a touch of rosin to this new age IPA. So, Hop Valley, Eugene, Oregon, those of you on the West Coast, check them out if you can find them. Really good brew. They've got a VIP, a vanilla-infused porter, which was my favorite beer I had from there. Had it one night before we got to Eugene. We were actually in Newport, overlooking the ocean, sat there, drank that bad boy, that 22-ouncer. Man, was it good. But cheers. So tonight, I got a little cube of cards. Not going to go through all of them. Came across these not that long ago. And what drew my attention was that first card, if you saw it. And that is this 77 Walter Payton. Horribly miscut top to bottom, but glad to have it. Wax stains on the back. Like that one. We'll save those for later. We have a 77 Dave Winfield with the Padres. Jeff Seaman, linebacker for the Vikings. This is 76. Like that one. Here's a Hostess, horribly miscut Dave Winfield. Like that one. I can see that sticking out. Here's a beat up and taped Alan Page. Well, what do we got here? What was this from? 75? 75 MVPs. Well, 75 MVPs of other years. 63 in this one. Elston Howard and Sandy Koufax. Next, we have a turn back the clock from 72. Nate Colbert belts 5 home runs. Not going to cover that. Here's a 77 Bob Avellini. The Bears. Oldest player to hit safely in a game, Minnie Minoso. Alrighty. Oh, we have a 76 Buddy Bell. Good color on the back, especially. Miscut left to right. That'll go into my 76 set. Yeah, I started that too. Let's see, these are 75, Steve Holden with the Browns. Another 75, John Mendenhall with the Giants. Here's one that I enjoyed. It's creased, it's beat up. But a 73, Hank Aaron. I've got one even more miscut than this, if you can believe that. It's your Bob Watson with a big piece of tape going across the bottom there, right there. If you can see it or not. One of my favorite Royals ever, John Mayberry. First time I ever saw a game in Royal Stadium, he hit one off the base, just about to the base of the scoreboard in dead center field. Just a minute. Oh, we have a 71 Phillies team card in the not the best of shape. Hall of Famer Bruce Sutter, 77 of the Cubs. I don't know what the hell, really bad corner there. Oh, a little Pete Falcone, 76 traded. Another 76 traded, Jack Brohammer. The red White Sox hat there. Mr. Johnny Briggs with some more tape. 73. We have an A's make it two straight. Game two of the World Series. Let's see, this is a 70. All-time home run leaders. I've got another copy of this, but I think it's off-center. The other way. I think it's more at the top that's off cut than the bottom. Oh, what do we got here? I think this is a Fleer in action. Yep. Oakland Raiders 3-4 shut the door against the Chargers. I never used to like those cards, but I like them a lot more now. Here we have a much better cut. Nolan Ryan hostess card. There's the back. Didn't know that was in there. Let's see, gotta get these out this way. We have a Lenny Randle with the Rangers. 75 Pepe Frias, the Expos. One of my favorite players, Cesar Cedeno. Always loved him with the Astros. Those old unis with the orange hats, love that hat. I'm gonna have to look at getting me one of those hats. A couple of my all-time favorite Vikings player. This was the first jersey I ever owned. None other than Mr. Chuck Foreman. Guy was a beast. Here's the 75 record breaker. Broke the record for running back catches, pass catches by a running back at 73. And we have a 76 traded Bill Melton and 61 Ron Pache, kind of beat up bad corner, look at that. And then we have these, let's see, we've got, I don't know what year they are. This one was interesting. This is a Freedom's War, U.S. Army photo of Dwight D. Eisenhower. Gotta be honest, I didn't see this the first time I kind of thumbed through. If anybody knows anything about it, let me know. There's the back of it. And then we have these three cards. We have Mr. Gene Bearden. Here's the back of it. It's got a big crease right below him there. You can kind of see it in my middle finger. Otherwise, it looks pretty good. Here we have a John Wyrostek, the Reds. I'm going to finish that up with a Cub. None other than Emil the Antelope Verbin. Going to have to do some looking into that one. This one's also got a crease right across the middle, but, you know, $6. That's what I paid for all those, $6. These were kind of hidden in the middle. I knew the Walter Payton was on top, and then the 76 top trade was on the back. And I bought it because $6 for the Walter Payton was worth it. But then to come up with these, the Dwight D. Eisenhower, could be his rookie card, I don't know. But thanks for joining me. Happy National Beer Day to everybody. And remember, collect what you love. Love what you collect. Cheers.